Hello, Buffy Stinchfield here, a physical therapist, specialist in women's health, pelvic health, the female athlete, and the dancer. Today I want to talk to you again about alignment. If you remember, I had another video where I had these, and I was talking about positioning or aligning the pelvis and the rib cage in line and stacking them well versus this. Now, I will also say I had someone ask me about this. This alignment issue is not just happening for postpartum women, but it's really common, and that's what I see a lot, even 10, 20 years after babies have been born. We often see this in young children and girls. We'll notice that maybe we use the word sway back, and we talk about how they're doing this. And if you look at the back, it looks like they're doing this. But if you just had them adjust their rib cage position, their sway back would go away. But what I wouldn't say for these kids, I would not tell you to have them suck it in. It's a cue that's often given to children, especially in gymnastics and dance, when we want them to change their alignment. We can tell that their alignment is off. And we say, well, suck it in. That is not the strategy that we want. We want to help them find their alignment. So usually helping them with our hands as teachers to get their rib cage over their hips is a better way to go. Excessive gripping of the abdomen is going to lead to pelvic floor dysfunction. And I see that a lot. That is my history of pelvic floor dysfunction, is that right there. So when we want to figure out our alignment, we want some more cues oftentimes. Maybe looking in the mirror is not doing it for us. And the explanation might work, but how do we make it happen on our bodies? So I have a dowel. I have this in my office and I use it quite frequently to help women get that alignment. So you're gonna take that dowel and you're going to put it along your back. And I'm going to move my back hand so you can see my spine. Now, if I am in a rib cage flared position or excessive anterior tilt, you're going to notice there's a huge gap between the pole and my spine. If I think about bringing my rib cage in to get my bra line towards the pole, you're going to see a much better alignment versus this. So it even would be a great before and after picture for belly and weight loss if you want to make it look like that. All you gotta do, change your alignment, bring your ribs over your spine, and you're going to notice a much better alignment. A lot of times women feel that there's a lot of work to be done right here in the upper abdomen just to bring that back down. That can help with diastasis or weakness up in here, or just helping get a better, stronger core. We're not talking about gripping muscles, we're just talking about using what we have, our muscles, to align us better. So if you have any questions, as usual, you can always message me on Facebook Messenger, or you can send me an email. Love to talk about this stuff. So I hope you guys have a good day. Thank you.